ball for round two. Both men step back for just a moment. That punch lands. Fighter relies a lot on their instincts and reaction time. You've got to get in there quick to punch your opponent before he gets his fist back to block.
To beat a counter-puncher, you've got to take them out of their face. Do not wait for them, because if you wait, they'll pepper and pop you all night long.
Rush. Very competitive round with 10 seconds left. That was almost a 10-8 round. Complete dominance.
You can't leave it up to the judges. It's up to you as a fighter. And the tournament's got a fight.
On to the third. Firepower here. It's knockout or bust for both of these fighters. It's the typical big man, little man argument. He's got to be quicker. He's got to move a lot to win this fight.
Plan is to try and change that game plan. Get him angry, get him frustrated, make him deviate away from the plan.
It's the typical big man, little man argument. He's got to be quicker. He's got to move a lot to win this fight. Exchanges from both men in this round. He misses with that jab. Another man really defends himself. We're not going to see as much footwork as the smaller weight classes in the heavyweight division, but we don't care. We want the heavy fists.
Seen it so many times. One punch changes everything. Sometimes when he hands down, they decide to showboat and show off, then bam! It's over. So they've got to stay sharp. One punch changes everything.
A very competitive round with 10 seconds left. Judging can be sometimes, there's no doubt who won that round.
Dominance, without a doubt, made look so easy.
Back at it in round four. Which one of these athletes is going to be the first to get rocked? That right hook. Yep. plays, finding a second win. I don't think I need to tell you which one of these fighters needs to find it.
Now this is about desire. This is about character. This is about want.
Nice exchanges from both men in this round. Both men step back for just a moment. Charge action from both of these fighters. Energy and endurance are not an issue for this fighter, who continues to be aggressive as the rounds wear on.
I've seen some aggressive fighters. They can terrorize the life out of you before they've even thrown a shot. The strength they have, the speed they have, and that knockout punch, they want to punch through you. They don't want to punch you. They want to punch straight through you. So you've got to be careful.
Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this one. They've got the momentum. They've got the advantage. How do they carry that into the next round?
So they don't get complacent. You think this is too easy. If they keep this same kind of pace up, they've got this fight.
Back into the fray here in round five. The courage on display here is incredible. Right hand just misses. When we talk about a fighter having power, don't just look at the head punches they throw. Look at the body shots. That can be the real difference.
Power. That power might be the do or die. That power might be the equalizer.
Nice exchanges from both men in this round. Neither man really defending themselves. The training scenes, the gym work, that's what it all boils down to. Who's going to have more endurance?
Midway through the fight, if you are tired, this can be the loneliest place in the world. If you cheated, now we're going to find out.
Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this one. Who has the advantage after that last round? Let's see what they have in store for us in the next one.
Dominance, without a doubt, made look so, so easy.
Here we go in the sixth round. With the left hook. Which fighter will say no mas? How much confidence do you build when your opponents hit you with their best shot and you walk right through?
This is when you get in the ring feeling like you're King Kong, because you know you've got a chin that is not going to get dented.
Nice exchanges from both man in this ring. He carries away that left hook. Swing and a miss. Endurance has been coming a factor. You can see this fighter having a hard time getting out of the way of punches, and they're not throwing as many on their own.
What can they change? Can they slow the pace down? Can they hit them quick to nick them out early? What can they do? They've got to concentrate and react. Because you know what you can do in the gym, you can do it in the practice.
Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this one. About who won that round.
I seriously hope the judges kept their eye on this fight, because if they haven't, there's going to be absolute uproar.
Raise the bell to start round seven. They both want the knockout. Really defending themselves. Can you believe what we're seeing? One of these fighters is starting to run out of gas. What do you do as a fighter when you just don't have the energy?
What can they change? They can change their attitude, they can change their nervous system for a certain amount of punches per round. Because otherwise, if they deviate from the game plan, they're going to be shattered once again, and the fight will be over.
And that just changes for both men in this ring. Just gets out of the way of that left hand. A scoring blow. Either man really defending themselves. Just missed with that big right hand. Round could go either way. 10 seconds to go. I promise you, all three judges here are going to give that round to you know who.
You can't leave it up to the judges.
And there's the bell for round eight. How do they use this fighter's aggression against them?
Sometimes when you have a fight, the best way to beat a fight is not give them what they want. Because they want to get you there. They want you to stand there toe-to-toe with them and have a tail. That's what they do in the gym every single day of the week. What you've got to do is you've got to frustrate them as they set their thoughts. Get out of the way. And they'll get so angry, so frustrated because they can't work.
Through the hook, it didn't land. You can tell he's stronger, but he's not faster. Some nice exchanges from both men in this round. Talk about punches and bunches. That's the mantra for this fighter with that exceptional hand speed.
I've never seen a fighter so fast in my life. How do you deal with this? You've got to hope they went out of steam.
Look at these men showing exceptional chins, by the way. Oh. fist at home. Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this one. Talk about a one-sided 3 minutes. We just saw
dominance without a doubt make look so, so easy.
Start round nine. Power is obviously the great equalizer in boxing, but when you know your opponent is relying on that so heavily, how do you deal with it?
Sometimes if you get in there with someone that's so powerful, you just gotta be smarter than him. You gotta be like a little favorite, a pickpocket.
Punch landed. This is certainly an aggressive fighter, but that doesn't always mean success. How many times have you seen a fighter chase a superior athlete around the ring and just get picked apart, even though they were the one pushing the tempo?
I've seen some aggressive fighters like this, and they are a nightmare. If you are not fit, that is the worst place to be. Having second thoughts in the ring.
And they figure out the combination to this set. Scoring left again. Either fighter willing to sit down on these punches, their arm punches, they're scoring, but they're not going to hurt your body. Big hook thrown, but it doesn't connect. Very close round with 10 seconds to go. See how they respond here in the next round.
So they don't get complacent. You think this is too easy? If they keep this same kind of pace up, they've got this fight.
The referee calling for seconds out. Unfortunately, this fighter not going to get more time to heal up and get a breather. This is the 10th. So far, it seems like aggression has been the key. This fighter just not slowing down.
How do you deal with an aggressive fighter? What you do is you fight fire with fire. You either give it them back because that's where they're comfortable, or you play calm, play cool.
So far, it seems like aggression has been the key. This fighter just not slowing down. Hook catching air. Which fighter will say no mas? Nice exchanges from both men in this round. They call it the chin. How strong is your chin? Do you have a glass chin? These are things that can affect the fight.
I've seen some fights with a granite chin. You can hit them with a sledgehammer, they are not going to move. But then I've seen some mad punches with a chin like a kick. As soon as you touch them, they're gone. This is the dangerous part.
Great heavyweight champions. His foundation appears to be okay, but when you put those gloves that high, you know that you're in trouble. A much better game plan here. Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this one. After what we saw in that last round, it's pretty obvious who has the advantage here.
I seriously hope the judges kept their eye on this fight, because if they haven't, there's going to be absolute uproar.
Here we go in the championship rounds, round 11. Hook misses. There's no doubt that this fighter's power can change the fight around in an instant. You can't afford to make one single minor mistake.
How do you know one of these fighters can knock you out with a simple jab? They're that powerful.
That hook didn't score. That punch. Neither man really defending themselves. No rest for the weary. Swing and a miss. This round still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. Stamina is always an issue in a prize fight.
It's when we talk about championship material.
For round 12. This is certainly an aggressive fighter, but that doesn't always mean success. How many times have you seen a fighter chase a superior athlete around the ring and just get picked apart, even though they were the one pushing the tempo? From each other and then run right back into trouble. And so far, the offense has been better than the defense. Exchange here from both men. From both men in this ring. You've heard the phrase, finding a second win. I don't think I need to tell you which one of these fighters needs to find it.
We've got two fighters that lack some movement and shatter. What makes you think? Willpower. Calm, because if you try it, you get desperate. You get desperate, you make mistakes. If you make mistakes, you get knocked out.
blocks that right hook. He misses with that jab. Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this one.
Unanimous.
You know what? Smart, smart that is. Totally changes styles to make sure they got it. At every round in the bag, there was no argument, no discussion, no mistake. It was so obvious.